हेलो मैम, गुड
हेलो,
आफ्टरनून मैम।
दिस इज रामपा फ्रॉम यूनिवर्सिटी। यस मैम, यस मैम, यू कैन जस्ट स्टार्ट योर क्लास।
ओके ओके, थैंक यू सर।
थैंक यू।
गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल ऑफ यू। आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फाइन। सो लास्ट सेक्शन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट स्टोर्ड फंक्शन एंड ऑल इन माय एसक्यूएल। सो इन टुडे सेक्शन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द माय एसक्यूएल कर्सर्स। सो व्हाट इज माय एसक्यूएल कर्सर and what are the properties of these cursors, and how you will create a cursor and how you will manage the cursor, that with the help of some examples we will illustrate the section. Okay, so let us go for the section with the help of a PowerPoint presentation. I will share the PowerPoint presentation to you. So our topic is MySQL cursor. So in the section, in the lesson, we have to go through the important sections or objectives. We have to know what is a cursor, and what are the main properties of MySQL cursor, and how to declare a MySQL cursor, and how to open a cursor in MySQL, and fetch a cursor and close a cursor. And this we will discuss with the help of some examples. Okay. So first of all, what is the purpose of a cursor? Why we are using the cursor? So a cursor allows you to iterate a set of rows returned by a query and process each row individually, just like a loop. In the programming languages, you know that just like a while, for loop. This why we are using that loops for the iteration purpose. You can continuously repeatedly do a process according to a condition. Okay, so like that, here if you are applying a select query, according to that select query, the details or the records it is selected and it's stored to a cursor, and whatever the records stored in the cursor, in that you can apply the iteration, or you can continuously traverse towards the records. Okay, so for that looping or iteration purpose we are using the cursor, and according to that traversal we can do some calculations or apply some condition and do whatever the process required within that records according to our desire. Okay, then MySQL cursor is a kind of loop facility given to traverse in the result of SQL one by one. So already I told you, most probably we are doing this one based the help of a select statement, and according to what is our select statement, according to that the result or that records will be stored or fetched to the cursor. And in that, the looping facility or iteration we are doing in the records one by one. Okay, then. So this is the concept of cursor. And next, what are the properties of MySQL cursor? So there are some conditions for traversing or operating this MySQL cursor. So three important properties we are going through. That is read-only. That is MySQL cursor is having the property read-only, non-scrollable and asensitive. So let us see what are the three properties in detail. First, read only. That means we cannot have the permission to edit the contents of the update the data whatever existing in the cursor. We can traverse and do some manipulations according to the values we are fetched from that based on the select statement. It is not having permission to update the data. So from the word itself it is clear, read only, we can access the data, not having the permission to update or edit the data. Okay, so that is the first property of the MySQL cursor. Then next comes non-scrollable. That means while you are traversing towards the each record one by one, you cannot skip some records or you cannot traverse from reverse order also. Just we can go from the first record to the second record, third record, like that. Only that movement is permissible in the case of MySQL cursor. Reverse movement or skipping, it is not permissible in the case of MySQL cursor. Okay, the next, as sensitive. So the cursors are of two types, that is as sensitive and insensitive. So let us see what is the difference between these as sensitive and the insensitive. A as sensitive cursor points to the actual database or actual data, whereas insensitive cursor uses a temporary copy of the data. So that means when you are taking this data to the cursor itself, there is no temporary data or temporary data is not formed. Whatever the changes you are making, it is done in the original database itself. That is called as sensitive cursor. That is accessing, or we are doing the operations or accessing based on the actual data. But in the case of insensitive cursor, within in between temporary local data will be created, and that operations or fetching is done from that temporary copy of that data. Okay, so and asensitive cursor is more faster than the insensitive cursor also. And remember, in MySQL cursor, it is asensitive. That means it points to the actual data itself. So you have to go through the three properties of MySQL cursor. The MySQL cursor is read-only, non-scrollable, and asensitive. So read-only means no updation is possible. Non-scrollable means you can move only just like first to second, like that movement is only possible. Reverse traverse possible. It's not possible. And also you cannot skip to a specified row, or you cannot skip the records. Then MySQL cursor is asensitive. That is, it is operating based on a main data or our original database. So it will be faster also. Okay. Then. Next. How the MySQL cursor works. So what are the operations coming under this? What are the things we have to do while operating the MySQL cursor? Okay. So first of all, you have to declare the cursor. First, you have to declare a cursor, just like declaring the variable. When you are using a variable, what you will do? You will declare, introduce that variable. Okay, what is the type of that variable? Like that, here also you have to declare the cursor. Okay, so what SQL statement it is taking, or what value it have to be get fetched, like that you will declare a cursor. After that, you have to open the cursor. First you declare, then you have to open the cursor. Then next, fetch the details to the cursor. So I told, declare means you just introduce the name of the cursor only. And fetch means according to the SQL statement, you have to take the data and fill the cursor. Okay, so the SQL statement will be mentioned, and the data according to the SQL statement or select statement is placed in the or fetched into the cursor using the fetch statement. Okay, then I already told this is a looping process or iteration process. So according to that, we have to check whether we reached the end of the record. So because it is a continuous process, when we are going, there will be 10 records, means after processing 10 records, it will reach the end of the record. Then we have to complete the process. Otherwise, if it is continued, means error will happen. So every time we have to check whether it reached the end. So in the same loop also, what you are doing in the normal looping, in the iteration, you will set a variable as 1. Then you will check whether our limit is reached. Then otherwise you will increment the value. Then again you will do some process. Then will check the value. So according to the condition only it is working. So here the condition is end of the record. Whatever you accessed and stored, fetched into the cursor, whether the end of the record is reached or not, you have to check it. then. If it is no, not empty, that means data is available, record is there, then what again you have to fetch the data. Okay, so I told her it is a looping process. First data fetched, then next it will fetch the second data, a third data, up to what? Whenever that cursor becomes empty. Okay, then empty means you have to close the cursor. So this is the operation. If this flowchart is clear to you, means almost the functioning or the operation is clear to you. Remember, according to this only we are operating next to the MySQL cursor. First you have to declare the MySQL cursor, then after that open the MySQL cursor, then fetch the details from using a select statement to the cursor, and check first data. When you taken data is there, okay, yes, then again you have to fetch the next day. Some operation will be done, that is according to our requirement. So something we will do anyway. Next again you will fetch the data. So this is a continuous process. Here the looping comes here, iteration comes here. Okay, then when it becomes empty, you have to close the cursor also. So what are the operation? Declare cursor, open cursor, fetch cursor, and checking the condition, last close the cursor. So next we are going to check how to declare the cursor, how to open the cursor, how to fetch the cursor, and finally how to close the cursors, and in between process also. Okay, let us see. First, declare the MySQL cursor. So what is the syntax of declaring a cursor? Declare, then user defined cursor name. You can give your user defined name for this cursor. Cursor name you can give a. Then next to cursor, because you are declaring a cursor, so declare cursor name, cursor for select select statement. So I told that. So our SQL, the whatsoever the statement, according to a statement only cursor is we are declaring. So you have to tell which select statement you are going to use. Just I will see and show an example, then it will be clear. Declare, okay. So you are giving the cursor underscore name, then cursor for select. So here the SQL statement is select name from student. So what happens, from the student database take the names. So only the field is name. It will take all the names from the student database and stored to the cursor name, the cursor underscore name list. Okay, so cursor name is the name of the cursor, and select statement is select query associated with the cursor. So now it is clear to you. Declare. Then next comes open the cursor. How to open a cursor? So I just remember the flowchart. The flowchart is in your mind, means it will be clear to you. First you declare, next you have to open the cursor. So let us see how to open the cursor. Open cursor name. Already we declared the cursor. So after that you have to initialize or open that cursor. Okay, so open whatever the name of the cursor, name of the cursor which is already declared. Okay, and some of the conditions are there. The open statement initialize the result set of for the cursor. Therefore you must call the open statement before fetching the rows from the result set. So you have to fill it. So before the fetching, you have to open the cursor. Then only you can fetch the details into the cursor. So remember that flowchart. First you declared, then you have to open. So next comes the fetching. So then use the fetch statement to retrieve the next row pointed to the cursor and move the cursor to the next row in the result field. So first you declared and applied the select query. So first data already will be there. Each fetch statement means just like you are going to the next values of I iteration. In the iteration variable, you are going to the next values like that. Here how it moves from first record to the second record by using this fetch statement. So fetch cursor underscore name into variables. So that is a must. So you have to do some operations. So you are fetching the data from the database and storing to a local variable. And according to that local variable, we are doing some operation and determining our anything, whatever we have to do. Okay, so fetch, whatever the cursor name I have introduced or declared or opened, that cursor name into variables. So when we are going for examples, it will be clear to you. Okay, so we are, whatever the, because we have already told there here, what will be the value? Select the name. So in the cursor, what is only filled? Name is only filled. So according to that name, you have to use the fields, whatever taken from the select statement, that fields we have to use the variables. For example, in the database, name is there, ID is there, marks is there. Like that means you cannot store everything to that, because in the SQL statement, the select statement, I declared only name. So you can store only name to that variable list. That also you have to remember. So if in your processing, what are the details required or the fields required, that all fields you have to fetch from the using the select statement. Then only you can use that variables. In your processing, only name required. In the select query, you can apply only select name from student. Clear? Okay. So anyway, syntax. Here you remember the syntax. In the example, we will go to the details. So fetch cursor name into variable list. So variable list means from that cursor, what are the fields to be stored to the local variables declared in the procedure. Okay. After that, check if there is any row available before fetching it. So condition also required that I will tell. Just next we will go for the closing operation. Finally, deactivate the cursor and release the memory associated with it using the close statement. Close statement means not only closing, whatever the memory we are used for that cursor, that also get released using the close statement, that is close cursor underscore name. Okay, whatever the cursor you declared, it is a good practice to always close a cursor when it is no longer used. So anything, all of you know, in the case of computer, anything if you are opening means it is better practice means you have to close it. Without a closing also, if it is MDA means you can proceed, but a proper practicing means you have to close anything opened after using. If you are not using for a long time, you have to close it. So here also you have to close the cursor, that is a close cursor name. Okay, no, not closing also error didn't happen, but good practicing means you have to close the cursor. Okay, clear. Then next I told the condition checking. So you have to know whether you reached the end of the section or end of the record. So that error or that condition is made possible using this statement. Declare continue handler. It will be fixed. I will tell the change what it comes. Declare continue handler for not found. Set one variable. Now here I used finished. You can use any name. You can use end of file, end of record. Any variable name is equal to one. So it is checking. That means this portion is implemented. This case is implemented using that statement. Okay. You have to check whether that data in the cursor is end of record or else to be continued. So that is done possibly using the statement declare continue handler for not found set finished only. Other else all syntax will be same, but finished is a user defined name. Okay, you have to tell a user defined name such like here it is used to finished. Other else you can use end of file or EOF, anything user defined name equals one. That means it reached a last. Okay, end of file is reached. Then what you have to do? According to a condition, you can terminate or leave from the procedure. So that I will explain in detail with the help of the example. Then it will be clear to you. Just I will go through what is written here. When working with MySQL cursor, you must also declare a not found handler to handle the situation when the cursor could not find any row. So what is happening here? Fetching the cursor is fetching the details, and there is no data, no record is there. That situation, that is called a not found. So that handler, not found handler, have to be, that comes here, handler for not found is have to be implement for checking the condition. Because each time you call the first statement, the cursor attempts to read the next row in the result state. So fetch statement means just like iteration. It will go for the next record. Automatically, one data fetched, it will automatically, the pointer moves to the next record. Okay, then when the cursor reaches at the end of the result set, it will not be able to get the data and a condition is raised. The handler is used to handle this condition. So when you reach the last position, so what happens? It is just like an error situation, nothing to do, no record is there. So to handle that situation only, we are using this not found handler. To declare a not found handler, you use the following syntax, that is declare continue handler for not found, handler for not found. Set, that is a variable we are setting. That is according to that value only. In that handler, when it is happening, no value is there. At that time, I am setting a variable as 1. That you can do in any way. Here, I am setting the a variable value as 1. Then later, I will check. If the variable value is equal to 1, means stop the process. No need to continue. We can leave the procedure or leave the loop. Like that, you can tell. Okay. So, it is clear to you. Now what we are discussing about the not found problem, not found handler you are using here. Okay, so it is clear to you. So we have discussed about this only. Now it is clear to you. First you declare the cursor, then you open the cursor. After that you have to fetch the cursor. Then while fetching, each time you have to check whether it is reached end of file, that is used with the help of or implemented with the help of a not found handler. And now already discussed with you, if it is value is empty, if it is not empty, means you can continue the process. When there is no record, you have to close the cursor. Clear? Okay. Next, we will go for the example sections. First of all, I will explain to you what we are going to do with the help of the cursor. Already in the previous sections also, we used the same table itself. So it will be easy for you. That's why same table I am introducing once again to you. I am having a table named student, and the structure of that table is ID, name, the marks of 3 subjects, mark 1, mark 2, mark 3, total and average. Just remember the fields, ID, name, mark 1, mark 2, mark 3, total, average. That means a student ID number, then ID, then name, then the subject, marks of 3 subjects, and total mark and average mark. Okay, and here primary key is ID. Just remember it. And ID is, name is only varchar. Then other else all are integers, and the average comes double also. Decimal point values are there. Okay, now structure is clear to you. The next, this already I have given some data to the table. Select a star from student. That's output is shown here. Now the table content is like this. It is having 12 rows in this one, 12 data I feed it. So, three marks given according to that. Earlier using the sub procedures, we have find out the totals, averages, okay, whatever may be. So, our structure, our table, student table is now having how many fields? 7 fields. ID, name, mark 1, mark 2, mark 3, total, average. Okay. So, make clear the structure of the table. Next comes to our cursor. Create a cursor to fetch the name of all trainees and prepare a name list. So just for understanding, making understand the cursor, what I am going to do is, I am using the table student. Then I am accessing the name of all the students from that table and making a name list of their student by concatenating all the names. That's only my purpose. Simple example. Okay, so I am There is a table named the student. From that table, I am taking all the names from the table and just concatenating the names within a single variable. I am going to join or concatenate the names as a list within a single variable. That's only I am going to do. Let us see what is happening here. Delimiter, you have to use, already I told, because our default delimiter is semicolon, because we are using a group of statements. So semicolon using means it will treat as the end of the statement. So we have to change the delimiter to some other variable, some other characters. So I am changing to double slash. So delimiter changed. Now with the delimiter is double slash, so end will be treated as a double slash. Semicolon is not end now, it will be a double slash. That, okay. Already the previous section I have discussed about the procedure. So now all of you are aware about the procedure. You know how to create the procedure and all. So I can implement the cursor within the procedure only. So first you create a procedure. Create procedure. What is the procedure name? Remember the names. Procedure name is list underscore name, because while executing this procedure only I can show the working of the cursor also. Okay, so the create procedure, procedure name is list underscore name, and in out, that also already I explained to you, it is a part of the procedure. In out means it is a parameter which pass get a value from the shell to the procedure and also returns the value in the same variable. So both function is happening here, in and accepting and returning also. Okay, so in out, then which variable is taking in and going out? Name underscore list where care. So that is the concatenated. First it will be null. Name underscore list, first it will be null. After that, concatenating all the names within this variable name underscore list. Okay, so that's why I given a size more, that is 250 size I have given, varchar of 250. Okay, then begin, all the multiple statements are there, the procedure you have to write within the begin end block. Okay, declare end of record integer default zero. Remember earlier in the syntax I told you about a finished in the not found handler. Set finished is equal to 1. So finished is not predefined word. You can use any variable for checking the condition. So here I am declaring a variable, just the end underscore of underscore record. That is end of record. Already I told I want to check whether the end of record is reached or not. So for that I am using the variable end of record, integer default 0. Then declare name list. Remember, this is not here the name list. Here it is name underscore list. Here what it is name list. Okay, both are different variable. This is local variable. Name list varchar 100 default. Okay, because why? Because that you have to fetch that data into which some variable. Already I told you have to take that variable value into the local variable, then only you can concatenate. Each time each name is accessing, so temporary for storing that name we are using this name list, and the final name will be in the name underscore list. Okay, let us next declare cursor for employee name. That is a command here. Then declare, what is the syntax? Cursor name. First you have to tell the cursor name. Okay, remember the syntax, declare cursor name. So what is the cursor name here? Cursor underscore name list is the cursor name. Then cursor for, you have to tell a select statement. So here what select statement? I told, already told you, I have to take the name of the trainees from the students from the student table. So select name from student, that's enough. No need to select all the data. Only I am going to concatenate the names, join the names. So only select name from student. Okay. Then next, declare not found handler. So already I told that we have to check the end of the record, whether the last record is reached. Then we have to stop the process. So declare, continue, same syntax it's following. Handler for not found set, same syntax, Next, set what is changing? Finished is equal to one. I told it's user defined name. So here I used which is end of record. You can use your own name. Set a end of record continuation statement. Here it is a void wrapped. That's why then end underscore of underscore record equals one. Okay, it is checking whether it is reached last. It's not over. Continuing. Then after that, now you declare the cursor. Next, you have to open the cursor. Open same cursor name. Cursor underscore name is here. Then next, you have to do a looping process. Our cursor itself, looping process, I already told, it's used for iteration purpose. So continuously something you have to do. Here what you have to do? You have to select each person's name. So now cursor, what it is having? Now cursor is having what? Cursor is having the result of the select name from student. Okay, and each and every data have to be fetched as like a loop. So all the names have to be stored in the cursor and you have to traverse the cursor one by one. Okay, then get name, loop statement already I explained in the control structures. All are related, that is why step by step I am coming. Control structures we have discussed in the last classes and all. Loop, then remember fetch. Here comes the fetch statement. You can write in the next statement also, next line also, no issue, is continued. Then fetch, what is the cursor name? Cursor underscore name list into local variable name list. So the first name now will be in the name list. Okay, then it is checking if end of record equals one, so that whether you reached the last, remembering that end of record, declare continue handler for not found. There is no record. For that only we defined that end of record. So it is checking if that variable become value become one, then leave statement also I told you that is to quit from somewhere. So here what it is told, leave end name, get name. So what is get name? Get name is a label. Okay, leave a label name. So get a name where I defined, that is loop, that is quit from the loop, come outside from the loop. Okay, no need to repeat. Okay, then next, now anyway first time value is there, so it won't happen. So it comes to the next, build the name list. I am going to concatenate or join all the names. So this condition is not satisfying at the first time, so set the name list is equal to, name list is our variable, result variable that have to be returned from that procedure. Okay, set name list is equal to concat. All of you know that concat is the function used to join the multiple strings, characters or strings. Okay, so concat name list. So name list now it is having the first name. Okay, then how you are separating the different names using semicolon? First name will come, for example, A, then semicolon. Okay, then first, what is the value of name list? We have to pass it. We will pass it as null. So first time you have to make the name underscore list value as a null. That we will do as an input argument. Okay, then name list, suppose it is null, means the first value will come here. Then now the name list underscore list is having the first name semicolon. Okay, then next what happens, end loop. So this end loop label, so it won't end, it's a looping statement, so again it will fetch the next data, so next name will be fetched. Then again it will check whether it is reached end of the file, so it is not reached. Then what again it will do, existing one name will be there now, so that name A semicolon I told, then it will fetch the second B, means B. Along with that, A, B is concatenated now. Again, semicolon, C, D, like that, whatever the names is there, that all the names will be concatenated and stored in which variable? Name underscore list. And remember, in the procedure, name underscore list is a return also. In, out, out means it have to be returned also. So now, which variable is having the concatenated name list? This name underscore list is having the list of the all the trainees name list. Okay. So after that, when the last record is reaching, if end underscore record equals 1 becomes true, then leave the loop. Then you have to close the cursor. Leave the loop means it will come here. Then close the cursor, end the cursor, and change the limiter to semicolon. Okay. So how you will execute this? Already I told that first you have to set the session variable. That's why underscore, at the rate we are using name underscore list equals null. Okay, just using opening and closing means it's equivalent to null. Then call procedure, how you will call? Using the call statement. Call, what is the procedure name? List underscore name, and passing this null value or this variable to that location. So it will take the reference and passing null, and processing is done. And the result also, in out variable means result also will be in the name underscore list. Inside the program, all the names are concatenated in the name underscore list. So to see the result, what you have to show? Select underscore name, at the rate name underscore list as name list means heading. For the heading you are giving as name list. So name list heading, and you will get all the names like this. Clear? So let us see the execution of these also. Okay, I will share the shell to you. One second. Share is the shell is now visible to you. Now I have initiated the, I already told we are using the swamper. Then I am going to initiate the MySQL server. Already initiated, and I am going to log in inside. So MySQL, you can use minus u root, and the no password is set, minus p. Okay, semicolon is not required. Then enter, password is not given, that is why I given enter. Let us see what are the databases. Same databases only I am using for all the sections. Show databases, data. Okay, so we go for the proceed with the CSA. So for using that, use CSA. Okay, let us see what are the tables. Show tables. Okay, we will proceed with the student. Okay, select star from student. Already I given the list everything in the PPT itself. This is our content. Okay, so now we are going to do is we are going to concatenate all these names, taking all these names and concatenating together. That is our aim of the, with the help of the cursor we are doing it. So I will copy that. What I explained, the same program only, just I have copied here. It is visible to you. Create a procedure list underscore name. So what I told, we are taking which statement is applied, select the name from student. All the names are stored in the cursor, and one by one names I am taking and concatenating and joining in that name underscore list. Okay, then next we have to execute it. Okay, so first I set name underscore, name at the rate name, set at name underscore list equals null. then it is okay. And the call list underscore name, then I pass with that section variable name underscore list as the reference. So the name underscore list null will be passed here, and finally concatenated all the names, and that is passing as a result also. So I have to print the value of select, which is the variable name underscore list. So if you want to get a heading, you can give your customized heading there. Name list. Okay. So let us see what is the output. So all the names are concatenated here. Okay. Because it's starting from here, one by one, it is concatenated and displayed it. It's clear to you. Okay. So now the execution is also over. Next, again, once again, we will go for the PowerPoint with a discussion of other examples. Second example. So, second example, a little change I have made. So, I have to take the names whoever having the percentage 100%, 10% whoever having the marks, total marks, scored the full marks, that student's details have to be joined together. So earlier it joined all the students' name. Here now only have to join whichever satisfies the condition, that is a full marks for the examination. So what change we have to do here? So you have to pass the percentage also. So in the procedure, you have to pass the percentage also. That is why here in percentage double 5, 2, because percentage or average mark is a double decimal point value. So in percentage double 5, 2 it is there. Then same as that of your name list, same, no change. All else are the same. And what in the select statement, there will be a change. Select name from student where average equals percentage, because I have passed the percentage 100 to the sub procedure. So it have to check how to take the select statement or the into the cursor, what data only have to be fetched whoever having only percentage 100. Okay, so that is why select name from student where average equals percentage. So 100 means here check average equals 100. Why average? In the database student, there the percentage is average, the field name is average, and here the local or the value I am passing is a percentage. So 100, if I am passing, average equals 100. That student's details only will be in the whichever cursor. Okay. So same, other else is same, no change. Only wherever the things I changed, one in argument, input argument changed, I am passing the percentage also. And here in the select statement, one change I have made, that is where condition applied, average is equal to percentage. Let us directly go for the execution. Once again, I will share the shell to you. Let us copy the program. Second program. Okay, already that procedure existing. How to delete the procedure? Drop procedure list underscore name by year. Okay, so I deleted. Then once again we will try. Okay, now it's success. So remember, what is the change? One input value have to be passed as percentage value, you have to send it. And here in the query applied select statement, select a name from student where average equals percentage. Okay, so let us go for the execution. So select name, again I have set it as a null, and call list. What is the name of that procedure? See here, list underscore name by percentage. Okay, earlier list underscore name, now by percentage I have given. List underscore name by percentage. Percentage I have to pass as the input argument. See here, how many arguments are there? Two arguments. That is a 1% and other in out result. What it is? Null only be first set. Then 100, whoever having 100 marks and name list first it is set to null, and final result also will be the name underscore list. Okay, so let us see. Select. Result will be name underscore list as name list. See, only 2%. Let us see. We can see that whether it is correct or not. Select star from student. We can check in that one. Who are having full marks? Radha and Vinci. So our output is Radha and Vinci. Okay, it's correct. So like that, conditions also we can apply. Then normally also we can do the cursor. So next, one more example I will discuss with you. Just I will show, first of all I show, will stop the share from you. Okay, then we will go to the PPT once again. Second example also over. Next we will go for a third example. That is, I am going to create a new table based on the student table. Okay, my aim is, just go for the question, create a cursor to fetch the details of all the trainees and insert the result into another table named the progress card. So already I am having a table student. So what are the things there? ID, name, subject marks, then total and average only. I am going to create a new table progress card with the same contents, with ID, name, and what percentage. Okay, so percentage, I think instead of percentage, later I have changed. So here I forget to update. So now I will make the change. We can make it as result, it's better. Result. So later only I changed the plan, so we can make it as varchar of 5 or 6. Okay. So it's better. So my plan is just like this. You can see result. If it is visible to you, it is clear to you, I will show you the result. I have to get like this. That is ID, name, whether the student is pass or fail. If you are seeing here, here one student failed. So like that, a new table I have to create. You have to fetch the details from one table and insert the data into the other table while, and you have to check whether the student is pass or fail. Because result ek field, there is no field. Okay, so you have to check whether a student is pass or fail and write that additional detail into the other table. So that is my aim. Now I think the question is clear to you. Now the details in the student table, from there you are taking the details, fetching the details into the cursor and checking the marks, and according to what is the condition of getting whether he is pass or fail. Is three subjects, suppose I am getting a, I am setting a limit there. If he is having three subjects more than or equal to 40, okay, if he is each subject mark greater than or equal to 40, then I will tell he is pass, and that is entered into the other table called the progress report. If it is less than 40, any subject, any mark less than 40, he will be failed. Okay, that is I am going to do. So let us go for the program. What I have done here, simply no arguments. Create procedure, cursor demo is the procedure name. There is no in arguments, out arguments. Okay, same thing. End of record, integer, default 0. What is the purpose? Node hand, node found handler, For that, I am declaring the variable end of record. Then declare roll number M1, M2, M3. These cases are what are local variables, because I want to get the roll number. Okay, I want the roll number. The name is here in the second line. Yes, name. So these details I have to fetch and store it into the local variable, because I have to write into other table. Okay, and M1, M2, M3, not I am going to write. I have to check whether it is greater than or equal to 40. So roll number and name to write in the next table. I am fetching it into a local variable, M1 and M2, M3, for the conditions checking. Okay, then next. So like that, 3, 4, 5 variables I have declared. Yes, name is Vyarka. Okay, then again cursor. Declare cursor 1 is the cursor name. Cursor 4, select. What is the select statement? Select ID, name, and 3 subjects mark I am taking from the student table. Not total and average. Only ID, name, mark 1, mark 2, mark 3. ID and name for writing in the next table. And mark 1, mark 2, mark 3 for check the condition. Okay, then next. Same statement, declare continue handler for not found, set end of record equals 1, checking whether it is reaching last record. Okay, then open the cursor, open cursor 1. Okay, then next, again loop, same procedure, loop must be there. What if we are doing in the loop? Fetch cursor 1 is the cursor name into which variables? Roll number, local variable I told, roll number, S name, M1, M2, M3. Our field names are ID, name, mark 1, mark 2, mark 3. So we have to introduce local variable. Then end of condition is checked. And what is our processing? If M1, now the student mark, first student mark will be in roll number, S name, roll number and name will be there. Mark will be in M1, M2, M3. And I am checking if M1 is greater than or equal to 40 and M2 greater than or equal to 40. And 3 conditions have to be satisfied. M3 greater than or equal to 40. Then what you have to do? Insert into progress card. I already created the structure. You have to create the table. Then only you can insert, create table. Everything I formed, I shown the structure to you. What are the fields of that table? Roll number, name, and result. Result means a pass or fail. I have changed it to result. Result, pass or fail. So roll, here, what is the roll number? That first student roll number will be inserted. His name will be inserted. And if he is satisfying condition, pass will be written. Yes, what happened? Roll number, name, fail will be written. Okay, so if he is pass, all the marks are greater than or equal to 40, roll number, name, and pass will be inserted. If it is not satisfying, what will be written? Roll number, name, and fail will be written. Clear? Okay, this is the condition. So what happens? It will repeat it for all the trainees. Okay, first trainee, then again fetch will looping statement only. Na? So it will go for the next fetch. Then again it will check if it is pass means pass return, fail means fail return. So all the 12 records, it will be written into the progress card also by determining pass or fail. Okay. So let us see whether what will be the output, then how you have to execute, call the function name, and you have to go, call the function name means a new table content is created. You have to check the table whether it is there or not. Okay, so let us see. Go for the execution. I will share this shell to you once again. So I will, first of all, I will describe you the structure of a progress card. What is the table name? Progress card. See, ID, name, result. ID, name, result. Okay. So int varchar. So I have to store the ID number, name, and result password. Okay. So next. I will copy the program to program from there. Okay, it's success. So it is clear to you. Already explained, insert all the things. If it is a satisfying pass, otherwise a failure. So how you can call it? Call, what is the name of the procedure? cursor demo, CUR demo, CUR demo. Okay. So toll rows affected, toll records are there in the student also, na? So list we will see what is the output of that. Select, start, from, what is our new table? Progress, car. Okay, see? Okay, only one student is failed. So we have to see that student table also, na? Whether that marks and all correct or not. Select, start from student. Spelling is mistake. Student. Okay, see? Here all satisfying. Pass. This also pass. This also pass. See here Anu. 2, 2, 2. 30 marks only. Other else all students are passed. Here Anu only having 30 marks less than 40. So she will be failed. So see here Anu is only failed. Other all rest of the trainees are passed. Clear? So like that, different type of operations can be performed with the help of the cursor. So you have to make clear what is the concept of cursor. That's all. Okay. So once again, we will go back to the PPT for the summarizing. So in today's section, we have discussed about the cursor and the properties of cursor. And how to, what are the operations happening in the cursor, that is clear from this flow chart. You have to declare the cursor, then after that open the cursor, then you have to fetch each and every time the details from the cursor. So that cursor data, it is having record means you have to continue the process. If you reach at the end of the record means you have to stop the process. Finally, you have to close the cursor also. So these are the operations mainly you have to perform within the cursor. So all the syntaxes in detail we have gone through, and we have discussed all the examples regarding it also. So I hope that all of you have understood the concept of the cursor with the help of these three examples. So according to our requirement, any operations can be done with the help of this cursor, and only you have to remember what are the operations related to the cursor have to be happened. That is clear from this flowchart. Okay, and just remember the syntax for that operations. Any queries, you can message to me, chat with me. Asking the PPTs, let me save it. Ravinder is asking what you mean by declare and cursor here. So that's only I'm explaining here itself. So mainly here the advantage of cursor means you can do looping. First you have to declare a cursor means just like a variable, you have to introduce the cursor to that sub procedure. And you have to tell a cursor I am going to declare using, and which data have to be stored in that. So that only you are telling in the select statement. And the looping is possible. Iteration is possible. Okay.